the creation lab and pick a hatchery bay. There's enough genome data for your first viable dinosaur.
The machinations of the ambitious, undoing extinction, playing with nature's laws. What can possibly go wrong?
Come on, Doctor. You know we've learned so much and invested even more in our Jurassic operations since the last time.
Yes, Mr. Finch, yes, the last time. There's always a last time and a next. Life. It begins. The most precious moment. The result of incalculable actions and reactions, trials and errors, genetic mutations and unknowable combinations, chaos, all leading to a living, breathing, thinking being, an entity, distinct and unique. And now we, you, just manufacture them. So, well done, I guess.
The Hammond Foundation has three main areas of interest: security, entertainment, and science. I've already nudged the heads of each division to reach out to you personally. They'll offer opportunities and incentives for you to be part of their team. Choose one of their contracts. It'll help you develop your facility.
Ah, Dr. Dua. This is our new Director of Operations.
I'm aware, Cabot. I'm Dr. Dua. I run the science division of our operation. Okay, you're going to need to build your reputation in the science division. Not easy with me around, but you'll manage. That means managing our dinosaur population and seeing that they are flourishing.
Contracts can be requested from the division heads inside the control room. Complete these to increase your reputation and gain additional revenue to keep expanding your park. So, one more thing. Your reputation. Your rep, quote-unquote. Keep an eye on it, okay? If you have a solid reputation with a division, you're more likely to benefit from them. Financially, I mean. But, like life, it's a balancing act. Each division is vying for your attention, and if they don't get it, they tend to take it personally. Good! Your first expedition team is out. They'll bring back what they find to the Fossil Center for... is simple, really. Create dinosaurs, which attract visitors to your facilities, brings in capital, money, huh? Which means you can do more research to build better facilities and create more dinosaurs, and there you go. A circle of life, development and resources, nature and commerce. See? Simple. People think money makes the world go round, but they're wrong. Contracts make the world go round, my friend. Obligations and commitments. Complete a contract and your rep with the science division will increase. Meaning you'll be able to take on more complex and challenging missions.
I've got an interesting opportunity work together to create life. Pure life. If you've been listening to Dr. Malcolm, then you know how important this is to us. And to me. I knew you were my kind of person. Inquisitive, driven. And I knew you couldn't resist this opportunity. So let's get started. Together, we can create a more authentic version of our dinosaurs. That means a complete genome. And I think you are up to the challenge. Don't disappoint.
Should extract genomes from fossils that have been collected inside your fossil center. That will increase the amount of viable data you have to create dinosaurs. The Research Center lets you improve your park in various exciting ways. New buildings, upgrades, and more await.
I'm Owen Grady, Owen to my friends. I've seen things I'd rather not talk about, but it hasn't dampened my commitment to the dinosaurs. The raptors, more generally, and me and Blue specifically. We have a special relationship, like what I have with Claire. Less complicated. Anyway, nice to meet you.
Thank you.
I have you to thank, at least in part, for where I find myself. Now we need to incubate, hatch, and house our dinosaur. Then we will know if our efforts will have been worth it.
This dinosaur, the Edmontosaurus, was originally uncovered at a site in Canada. I'll let you guess where. The T-Rex thinks these are delicious.
I'm Isaac. I've been hearing good things about you. I'm in charge of the entertainment division. What good is the world's greatest show if no one sees it? Don't answer. It's rhetorical and painfully obvious. What I'm saying is that we need people in our parks. Fill up our facilities with warm bodies. Numbers bring revenue, excitement, and opportunities.
With dinosaurs is that they have no point of reference to understand humans, so don't expect them to be animals.
I've been monitoring what you've been up to with great interest, and I'm a little disappointed that Dr. Dua came to you for this assignment instead of bringing me into the loop as she should have done. I'll discuss this with her later.
Thank you. site selection as the helicopter is standing by.
I'd work with you anytime. Hey, it's Isaac. How you doing? I got some cool stuff you need to be a part of, so I'm putting it out there. Come on and help the winning team. Mine. Saying is, let's get some fresh dinos in the hopper.
I don't know what's worse, treating these creatures like grist for the mill or propping them up as curiosities.
I see you've had some triceratops. Might be cute now, but that's only gonna last for about a week.
Thank you.
you can help with this, and you should. We need pictures of what we are doing here, and a contract is available to reward you for doing so. Look it over.
Been on these islands before. On Isla Nublar, I made some mistakes and I tried to set them right. I believe in what we're doing and I believe in these dinosaurs.
Happy guests is what we strive to maintain. We do that by making sure their needs are met. In a way, it's kind of like taking care of the dinosaurs with more demands and less understanding. Am I right?
Thank you.
Looks like you've run out of power. That's not good. Build more power stations or increase your output.